Welcome to Paradigms of Computer Programming. I'm Peter Van Roy, and I'm going to be teaching this course. This course is an introduction to programming in four themes: functional programming, mathematical formalisms for programming, semantics, different forms of semantics, data abstraction, and concurrent programming. We're going to see the three most important paradigms, in my opinion. First, functional programming, which is a form of declarative programming, object-oriented programming, and concurrent programming, which is extremely important. So before we start, we have to set the stage. So the first question is, what is a programming paradigm? Because paradigm is an extremely overused buzzword. Well, for this course, I'm going to give you the following definition. A paradigm is an approach to programming a computer based on a coherent set of principles or a mathematical theory. So in practice, it's a set of data types, set of operations and techniques for building and reasoning about programs. So many useful paradigms exist, and programming languages, different languages, support various paradigms, such as Java, Scala, Haskell, Erlang, Prolog, and so on. So we would like to study all of these paradigms, as many as possible. The problem is, in order to do that, do we have to study many languages? Because usually languages support only a small number of paradigms. So each language has its own syntax, has its own semantics, is another system to install. So installing many systems, many syntaxes, many semantics, it's not really practical. So for this course, we have a pragmatic solution. We're going to pick one language, which is a research language designed to support many paradigms, also known as a multi-paradigm languages, and the language is called Oz. It's a research language that has been developed for many years and has many possibilities. So with this, we can get the language issue out of the way, and the emphasis of the course will be on paradigms, techniques, concepts, not so much on the Oz language as such, because the techniques, you'll be able to apply them to many different languages. Okay, now we have a language. How can we present many paradigms? So each paradigm is a different way of thinking. So how can we present different ways of thinking in the same language? Well, in fact, it's possible, because paradigms, even ones that seem to be very different, have much in common. So we can present the paradigms one by one, stepping from one paradigm to the next by just adding the concept that's necessary for the new paradigm. Each paradigm has a simple core, which we call the kernel language, with a simple syntax, simple execution, and a small number of concepts. So practical languages such as C++, Java, and so on, with very rich syntax, lots of tools for the programmers, seem complicated, but in fact they can be all defined in terms of the simple kernel language. And a practical language, a program in this practical language, can be translated easily into the kernel language. So this approach works well for practical languages as well, rich languages. So this is kind of an example of the scientific method. We decompose the thing, which is the language, into the primitive, simple elements that compose it. Okay, so the kernel language is the one containing these simple elements. So we will start with a simple kernel language in this course, which implements the first paradigm of the course, which is called functional programming. And then we will add concepts one by one to go into the other paradigms. This way, we pack as many concepts as possible with a minimum amount of effort. Each concept is only added once. Okay. Given the limited size of this course, we will only learn a few paradigms. They are the three main ones, in my view. You can see, you can disagree with that. You'll see what the different ones are. The other paradigms are also interesting, and you can learn about them in other places, such as in the course textbook. We will only see about one third of the textbook, but the other two thirds is also very interesting and has lots of interesting paradigms. Okay, so now let's get concrete. Okay, you know some programming languages: Java, Python, C++. Most likely you know already an object-oriented language. An object-oriented programming, which has a coherent set of principles, is clearly an important paradigm. But what are the other paradigms that we should learn? Isn't object-oriented programming by far the most useful and important one, given that it's so widely used? Actually, it's not. Many other paradigms are extremely useful, in many cases more useful than object-oriented programming. For example, to make robust and reliable and high-performance programs on the internet, which is a distributed system having failures, object-oriented programming is just not the best. The best is a concurrent paradigm that supports isolation of different parts. Another example is programming complex problem solving. Programs that try to solve complex problems, planning, scheduling, playing games. One of the best paradigms there is constraint programming, also which has not much to do with object-oriented programming. Okay, so now that we've set the stage, in the next lessons, we're going to talk about the practical organization of the course, and then we'll dive right into the concepts.